Gurudam Granthadam Namadam Dhamadam Muja Bhaktidam Bhuridam Bandi Bhakti Vinodakam Sada. Gurudam Granthadam Namadam Dhamadam Muda Bhaktidam Bhuridam Bandi Bhakti Vinodakam Sada.
Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking that Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinod Thakur identified himself at the sweeper of Namhatta. See, Namhatta was established by, opened by Sriman Nityananda Prabhu, and Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinod Thakur identified himself as the sweeper of that Namhatta. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur speaking, Bhaktivinod Thakur means Gaudiya Math. Everything we are getting from Bhaktivinod Thakur, Prabhupada speaking, actually we are getting everything from Bhaktivinod Thakur. Now we will have to keep patience and go through those, you know, writings and speeches, everything by Bhaktivinod Thakur under the guidance of Guru Varga. Then we can get everything. Actually, more precisely we like to say that Gaudiya Math is equal to Bhaktivinod Thakur and Prabhupada, both. And Prabhupada speaking, actually Chaitanya Math means Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. Prabhupada speaking, Chaitanya Math is the source of that original Chaitanya, Purna Chaitanya, Chaitanya Vastu is the source, that Chaitanya Math. So Chaitanya Math is equal to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. And you can remember that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu enlightened, you know, fire, yajna, started yajna, nam yajna, in Siva Sangan. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started nam yajna, enlightened yajna, Sankirtan Yajnagni. And those who are actual Gauriyas, Gauriya devotees, Prabhupada speaking, if they are ready to sacrifice their life in that fire, Sankirtan Yajna, which was enlightened by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if we can sacrifice our life and there into this fire, Sankirtan Yajna, then we are actual Gauriya. Otherwise, we are not Gauriya. Actually, if we can maintain this quality, then we are Gauriya. Otherwise, we are not Gauriya. We cannot identify ourselves as Gauriya devotees. Actually, many devotees, so-called devotees, they cannot understand the mood of Bhaktivinod Thakur. Many devotees, even those who are staying in Radha Kundo, they also speaking that Bhaktivinod Thakur is our line, in our line. They are speaking this way. Lalita Prasadji, I mean, I don't like to elaborate this point. They deserve Bhaktivinod Thakur is in our line. And they are also passing different kind of sahaja remarks. We cannot accept it. Actual point is that the maximum people, most of them, they cannot understand the actual mood of Bhaktivinod Thakur. Raganugamu, Rupanugo Varayate. In the Dandavat Pranam of Bhaktivinod Thakur, we say Rupanugo Varayate. Rupanugo Bar, Bar means topmost. You see. After Bhaktivinod Thakur gone in the year of 1914, Bhaktivinod Thakur took birth long ago, 18 something. After that, for a long time, he is doing, you know, his own study, everything in Ula. Ula, you know, at Birnagar. Just from Krishnanagar, 2-3 station. Birnagar, Ula, Birnagar. Originally, Bhaktivinod Thakur, you know, he took birth there. And from childhood, he's showing extraordinary mood, always. After that, he started education in Gwari. Gwari, you know, Krishnanagar. Krishnanagar, there, education started. Anyway, but when Bhaktivinod Thakur, I am going to discuss about the speciality of Bhaktivinod Thakur. Actually, all our Guru Varga, like Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad, Paramahansa Keshav Goswami Maharaj, everybody. There is some ontological aspect and morphological aspect, two aspects. As Vaishnavas, if you want to discuss about the in Siddhanta of Bhaktivinoda Thakur or Guru Varga, any appearance day, it is good. If we like to see, if we like to understand a Vaishnava, we must understand his Siddhanta. It is the right way. Otherwise, physical appearance, is black or white, is tall or short figure, is not Vaishnava Darshan. It's not actually Vaishnava Darshan. Paramjit Keshav Goswami speaking, we have seen in the life of Prabhupada, Leela, whenever appearance day or disappearance day of any Vaishnava coming, we have seen Prabhupada discussing about his Siddhanta, Vichar. This is a way to understand a pure Vaishnava. To understand a pure Vaishnava is the actual way. Now, point is that when Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, just in the year of 1914, you know, before Rajyatra, Gundija Mandir, previous day. After that, those who are Sahajiya, they are passing different kind of remarks in front of Prabhupada. They are speaking, Prabhupada, you are so harsh, you are so heavy. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was more liberal. We have seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur calling Sahajiya Kirtaniya party from Shantipur, Ganesh Kirtaniya, they are coming and playing nice Kirtan, everything, everybody enjoying. But you never allow. Why? Prabhupada laughing. Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur just gone. Now he have started passing this kind of dirty remarks about Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And if I go away, what you can speak? In whole life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur never supported any Sahaja Siddhanta. Never. Whole life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, speech, everything. Actually, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was the first person. He was the first person to represent Gauranga, you know, Gauriya philosophy in front of those foreign people. First, he was the first personality to represent Gauranga Darshan, Gauriya Darshan, in front of all people, different foreign people especially, in different language, Hindi, Bengali, Sanskrit, English, Urdu, different language Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak. You can go through the life history of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you can find that time, long ago. Actually, after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gone, within 2-3 years, a darkness came. Oh, nobody liked to follow Chaitanya. He's dirty. He's Vaishnava Darshan, so dirty because in the name of Gauriya Bhajan, those who are Sahajiya, they are saying all rubbish. That's why those educated people, if they hear about Gauriya Bhajan or Chaitanya Mahasamrita, is go. Used to hate so much. So much hatred created. They are responsible for that, their character, their behavior, their siddhanta, all rubbish. Used to stay with, you know, Sakhi. They used to stay with, you know, woman doing bhajan. This way, everybody used to hate. They cannot understand. Even I can give one example. It's very important. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur told himself. That's why I am speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, you see, on those days, actually, Raja Ram Mohan Rai, Keshav Chandra Sen, the big, big figure, they are not actually spiritual figure. But they want to prove we are spiritual figure. Brahma Samaj, you know, they established by Keshav Chandra Sen. And this Raja Ram Mohan, that time, 300 years ago, approximately, 250 years ago. Approximately. He is a big social reformer. So people used to show too much honor to him. One day, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, one day, Raja Ram Mohan Rao decided to take some knowledge about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Siksha. That day, when all told darkness all around, those who are Jati Gosai, everything, all rubbish they are doing. Only money, woman, position, rank, enjoy your life. In the name of Chaitanya, Gauriya Bhajan, they are doing all rubbish that time. He thought, somebody is speaking, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sampradaya is very good, his Siksha. But we see all rubbish here. Actually, I like to get some knowledge about it. I can try to get some knowledge. Then he approached Sahajiya Gosai. And he asking, can you speak something about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings? Yes, I can see. Sit. He's speaking. After that, he is speaking, oh, rubbish philosophy. Then Raja Ram Mohan Rai, this block his eyes, everything, and gone. Is so dirty thing, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya. All darkness. Before Bhaktivinoda Thakur coming, all around darkness. Then seventh Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur when came, then we can get some light gradually. And now full light. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur came, after that Bhaktivinoda Thakur was a so big writer. You cannot imagine. On those days, there is Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, everything, so big writer. But if Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to write some material thing, then they cannot stand in front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur never care for Patishtha, La Puja Patishtha. Never care. She wanted to write something what is absolute truth. Bhaktivinoda Thakur started writing. First of all, actually Bhaktivinoda Thakur, after completing education, the financial condition was very poor. Because they are actually Mustafi, very rich man. They are their forefather or rich man. You can go to Gaya, you know, Gaya, Pret Gaya, you can find one nameplate there. Full Pret Gaya, full staircase, everything, temple done by as forefather, big rich man. But gradually, their condition, financial condition, fall down somehow. Now somehow Bhaktivinoda Thakur managed to take education in Gwari. Very critical situation. After completing education, actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur manifests this Leela. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is a student of Vidyasagar. You heard Vidyasagar, name of Vidyasagar? Hiranyakasipu. It's big, you know, Sanskrit grammar wrote. Big, learned man. But he's not Vaishnava. But he's open-hearted. Not like Vaishnava, but still good. So he took education from Vidyasagar also. It is Leela. Who can give education to Bhaktivinod Thakur? So Bhaktivinod Thakur took education from Vidyasagar Mahasaya. Vidyasagar used to love Bhaktivinod Thakur very much, very much. Kedarnath Datta, previous name, Kedarnath Datta. But actually, Sanskrit College, he was the principal of Sanskrit College, that Vidyasagar. There actually one day, Vidyasagar giving, you know, lesson. And in the meantime, Bhaktivinod Thakur stand up and asking, Jay Pandit ji, you are speaking that Bhagavan is formless, this, that, you are passing this kind of remark. Now my question is that, have you seen Supreme Lord? You are passing Bhagavan in nirvishesh, impersonal, you are explaining this way. So it is my request, could you speak any example, perfect? Have you seen Supreme Lord, so that you are speaking this way? Because you, I mean Bhaktivinoda was speaking, you always speaking this way, what I cannot see, what I cannot understand, that I cannot speak. Vidyasagar used to speak this way, what I cannot see, what I cannot understand, that I cannot speak. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur asking, that means you already understand, you already have seen, that's why you are. Then Panditji, Vidyasagar stopped, silent, couldn't speak anything. From then, Vidyasagar could realize that boy is not ordinary boy. Then from then onward, he took special care on him. Even after completing education, when Vidyasagar could understand his financial situation, he arranged one service there in Orisha as a teacher, school teacher. After that, gradually, at the time of British time, that time is British time, gradual promotion, British people could know about his character, everything. They give high post, higher post. After the DM rank, you know already. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur whole life is, you know, always speaking about that absolute truth. So when Bhaktivinoda Thakur came here in Krishnanagar, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was there in Krishnanagar at DM, ADM. That time that, you know, that writer, big writer, who is writing Bande Mataram, writing, he wrote it, that man. His name is Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. He was also district magistrate. Then the question of changing portfolio came. Meaning he liked to change his portfolio, to give all papers to him, is going to some, Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to Shirampur, and he liked to get post here. Follow, he's posting here. In the meantime, in 7-10 days, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to give nice argument in front of that big writer, Bankim Chandra. But he was not ready to accept it. Not at all. He is not at all. Bhaktivinoda Thakur give you argument. This way if you can approach, you can get Supreme. Why? They are less interested, material people. Less interested. After that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, was, you know, given post to Puri, Purushottam Dham, by government. Is given this post to get control over this, you know, whole Jagannath temple activities. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in his life history, writing, that time, I got the scope to discuss all nice, you know, Gauranga Darshan, Gauriya Darshan, inside Jagannath temple. Jagannath temple, where those Brahmins, they are sitting in a big altar, you know, this Brahmin sitting inside. Jagya Bedi is Jagya altar. They are all Brahmin, they are sitting. Most of them are, they are believing impersonal Brahma. They don't believe. Bhaktivinod Thakur used to avoid that place. He used to sit in front of that Padapit. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Padapit is there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Padapit there. Bhaktivinod Thakur usually in the evening time used to sit there. Bhaktivinod Thakur in his life is to write that we used to call that place is Bhakti Mandap. Bhakti Mandap. And that is Mukti Mandap. That big Jagya altar is Mukti Mandap. And Bhaktivinod Thakur used to call it Bhakti Mandap. And all nice devotees in the evening time they used to get together. They sit and used to discuss all nice Siddhanta. Very nice Sankirtan, very nice. Still today you can find some Panda, they are doing Kirtan just there. This way Bhaktivinod Thakur used to do bhajan there all the time. But outside people, they cannot understand, they couldn't understand the mood of Bhaktivinod Thakur. Sarup Das Baba, one important Babaji in Puri, he couldn't realize the mood of Bhaktivinod Thakur. He giving order to those people, common people, don't go there. It's not Vaishnav. No Tulsi Mala, no Tilak, nothing. Don't go there. Speaking this way. Then after that Babaji Maharaj meet with some problem, bhajan problem. He is about to fall down. He wonder what happens? Oh, maybe I pass this kind of remark. Then he ran to Bhaktivinod Thakur and catches Lord Abhi. Excuse me, I couldn't understand your mood. Externally, I cannot see your mala. Maybe inside court. Because he is distinguished. I couldn't understand your mood. Please, you are Gauranga Parshad. Then after that, he revived his bhajan gradually. This way, actually, when Bhaktivinod Thakur was in charge of all Jagannath temple there in Odisha, then he was given enough power by government because he's an elevated personality. They could realize very important personality. You already know that point, that Biskishan one, you know, yogi is very notorious yogi. He used to do his yoga vaibhav in forest. In forest there. And he is, you know, so wicked personality. He used to already declare that on that Purnima, I am going to Ras. Ras, I am Krishna. I am going to Ras with all Gopikas. Yeah. Gradually, Bhaktivinod Thakur came to know about it. Then Bhaktivinod Thakur took step. I must control this problem. Then Bhaktivinod Thakur with whole troops, police force, went there. But that yogi is very powerful. He wanted to disturb Bhaktivinod Thakur. Very. He wanted to kill Bhaktivinod Thakur by yoga power. Bhaktivinod Thakur reading Bhagavatam and he is, you know, giving mantra. Then mantra running around, cannot touch Bhaktivinod Thakur. Bhaktivinod Thakur reading Bhagavatam, doing chanting Harina. And after that, he was caught red-handed and taken into jail. And there in jail, he is speaking very loudly, I can see what a man you are, Aisha. Huh? He gives threat to Bhaktivinod Thakur. And really so, Bhaktivinod Thakur is family member. They feel disturbance. Son, Sikh, daughter Sikh, this way. But very quickly, very soon, Bhaktivinod Thakur get rid. Mane go out of this problem. He catch and put him in jail for life. This way, Bhaktivinod Thakur giving punishment. After that, actually, Bhaktivinod Thakur started, while Bhaktivinod Thakur speaking, and when I was in Puri, I got the scope to go through different manuscripts of Goswamis. Because that time there is no written books. Paper was not there. Jiva Goswami Pad was the first personality who started writing in paper. It's at that time special paper. Dhulat paper, one special. Made of cotton. Some Bhaktivinod Thakur. Jiva Goswami. At the time of Akbar Badshah. But actually paper at the time of Bhaktivinod Thakur was not there properly. Special paper. Then Bhaktivinod Thakur was speaking, there I used to go to different, you know, writings of, I mean, Goswami's writing, everything. Then after that, there actually Bhaktivinod Thakur won so many books Bhaktivinod Thakur writing in his whole life. Especially when Bhaktivinod Thakur doing service in the tiffin time, you know, in break time, tiffin break, Bhaktivinod Thakur used to write kirtan. Bhaktivinod Thakur used to write kirtan, never take rest, nothing. This way, Bhaktivinod Thakur writing so many things. I mean, you can say Bhaktivinod Thakur Gaudiya Math is how you can understand. If you can understand Bhaktivinod Thakur, you can understand Gaudiya Math. If you can understand Bhaktivinod Thakur, then you can understand Gaudiya Math. Otherwise, no. Actually, that point, when those people complaining against Prabhupada, you are so hard. But Bhaktivinod Thakur used to allow this Sahaja Kirtan, I mean Ganesh Kirtan from Shantipur, this, that. Prabhupada speaking, in whole life Bhaktivinod Thakur never approved the Sahaja Kirtan, nothing. Yes, we have seen. In front of us, we, Prabhupada speaking, you cannot understand the mood of Bhaktivinod Thakur. Bhaktivinod Thakur used to do bhajan, harinam. Bhaktivinod Thakur, the mood of Bhaktivinod Thakur, you cannot understand. You have seen in front of Bhaktivinod Thakur some sahaji are doing kirtan, but what is the actual mood? Actually, Bhaktivinod Thakur sitting in sabha, kirtan going on. Why Bhaktivinod Thakur calling them? Because the ordinary people cannot understand my philosophy. At least if I can call them this way, if sahaji kirtan is there, all people can come. That time Bhaktivinod Thakur sitting, they can have the chance to look Bhaktivinod Thakur, Vaishnav Darshan Sukriti, can hear something. This way Bhaktivinod Thakur wanted to introduce strict Gauriya Darshan inside the heart of those common people. Otherwise Bhaktivinod Thakur never approved, never in whole life. Simply for this reason Bhaktivinod Thakur used to do kirtan. Arrange kirtan, but actually the mood of Bhaktivinod Thakur is, you cannot understand. This is actually. Now, I told you that Gadrum is so important place. Gadrum, out of 9 Ayat land, actually, Gadrum Deep is topmost, because Gadrum Deep actually is Kirtanakha Bhakti Khetra. Kirtanakha Bhakti Khetra is topmost. And that is also Bhaktivinod Thakur, it is also Nandogram. Nandogram, that place. So Nityananda Prabhu actually making, opening Nam Hatta. Bhaktivinod Thakur identified himself as the sweeper of that Nam Hatta. Just I told you, the Nam Hatta means where Harinam is available, pure Harinam. Nam Hatta means, if you think deeply, you can understand the meaning of Nam Hatta. Nam Hatta means the market, village market. Hat means village market. So Nam Hatta means where pure Harinam is available. Because those Mahajan, those who are Guru Varga, they are selling Harinam. But what is the price? Sadhya. Bhaktivinod Thakur also writing kirtan. Bhaktivinod Thakur also writing kirtan that Nodiya Godrume Nityananda Mahajan Patiyache Nama Hatto Jivera Karan. It is Bhaktivinod Thakur already writing this kirtan. Is very inner meaning is there. Prabhupada used to speak this thing. Nama Hatta means a big, you know, philosophy there. Actually, ordinarily you can understand is this village market, Nam Hat, where Harinam is being sold by Guru Bhargava. But what is the actual meaning? Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur identified himself as the sweeper of Namhatta? Because in Namhatta, at where pure Siddhanta, Harinam, Harikatha is being, you know, sung by Guru Varga, there if some dirty thing coming, Sahaja thing, dirty thing coming, then Guru Varga used to sweep out. Now, actually Godrum is Namhatta, okay. Godrum is Namhatta, so actually Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur identified himself as the sweeper of Namhatta. Why? Wherever there is Sahaja Siddhanta, Siddhanta Virod Rasavas, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to sweep, throw. Today is a big problem. If we cannot maintain Siddhanta, then our future generation can collapse. Nobody can stand. If we can protect Siddhanta, then everything is protected. Prabhupada speaking. If Siddhanta Bani is protected, then everything can be protected automatically. It's an automatic factor. If Siddhanta Bani is protected, then everything is protected. Prabhupada giving warning in front of us, actually be sure, Bhaktivinoda Dara never going to be extinct. Close. I feel disturbance. Today Harikatha, I am feeling disturbance. I am not feeling comfortable. Actually, Prabhupada speaking this way, actually Bhaktivinoda Dara never going to be extinct. Never. Bhaktivinoda Dara never going to be extinct. We can get Bhaktivinoda Dara forever. Maybe very secretly. Like Phalgu Nadi, you know, in Gaya, there is one river. Inside sand, you can find water. But up, there is sand. If you dig some sand, then you can find some water. But there is no water. Externally, you cannot find some small channel going off, channel of water going off, source of water, very poor. So, Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Dara never going to be extinct. It is not possible. Somehow, Bhaktivinoda Dara, we can find Bhaktivinoda Dara flowing. We can find Bhaktivinoda Dara flowing in this material world forever. Maybe one or two or three devotees must be there who can maintain this Dara. Then also Prabhupada speaking, you are devotee. Prabhupada speaking, if you can understand the difference between Bhaktivinoda Dara and Abhaktivinoda Dara, if you can understand the difference, this difference between Bhaktivinoda Dara, speciality of Bhaktivinoda Dara, and what is Abhaktivinoda Dara, then and only then you can be protected. That is called actually satsanga. Prabhupada speaking, to understand the difference between Bhaktivinoda Dara and Abhaktivinoda Dara, this is called actual satsanga. Prabhupada speaking, it is actually a secret satsanga. Then you can understand what is Bhaktivinoda Dara, what is not Bhaktivinoda Dara. Otherwise, you cannot understand. You cannot understand the mood of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So, I mean, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is writing any writings, Jaiva Dharma or anything, any Chaitanya Sakshamrita, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Siksha, any writing, Bhajan Rasa, any writing. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing means exactly what is there in Golok. Through language, it is quite impossible to represent the picture what is happening there. Only it is possible by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Only it is possible by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. It is quite impossible to represent, to write in language what is happening there. But only Bhaktivinoda Thakur can. What is happening there, exact thing, through language he can express, English, Bengali. So easy Bengali, so easy in English. 150 years back, the British people, they go mad, how possible that time so easy English, what do you call modern English, very easy. Bhaktivinoda used to write, so easy English, so sweet English, very easy. How possible? Bhaktivinod to write so easy English. Nam bhajan adi, so many, you know, you can find. Bhaktivinod to write. And the life and precepts of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Bhagavat, on Bhagavat, some, you know, special commentary on total Bhagavat. So many writings Bhaktivinod Thakur writing. For Bhaktivinod Thakur, actually, to be frank, for Bhaktivinod Thakur, at present we are looking this. Actually, for Bhaktivinod Thakur. Because then, 150 years back, he used to speak all, you know, Chaitanya Vani, Chaitanya Darshan, Gauriya Darshan, in front of all important people. Where not? Calcutta University Hall, Sahitya Parishad, big place, Bhaktivinoda used to speak. Even in the house of Rabindranath Tagore, you know, in the house of Rabindranath Tagore, speaking very nice. Nobody can cut his Siddhanta. So nice, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Anyway, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing so many books, if you can understand, then you can understand what you mean by Gauriyamat, what is called Gauriyamat. In Rambagan, in Calcutta, near Maniktala, one place. Maniktala, in Calcutta, there Bhaktivinoda Thakur made one building, Rambagan, there. And that time, while the, you know, foundation going to be prepared, then one shalgram was found. There is Kurma Shila. It's called Kurmadev Bhagavan. Kurmadev Bhagavan manifests from there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur clean and do abhishek and give responsibility to Bimala Prasad to worship. Now question can come. That time actually Prabhupada couldn't get initiation how worshipping can be done. You can do argument. But this kind of argument is totally prohibited here. Totally prohibited. Actually, foolish people, they cannot understand the mood of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They cannot understand. Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, if they want to pass this kind of remark about Prabhupada, it's not good. They cannot understand. Actually, that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur gave responsibility to him to care of that. It is possible for Bimala Prasad Saraswati. Then after that, there actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur make one society there. Brahmacharya Society, like that, I forget that name of that society. And he started writing articles in different papers. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. After that, Sajjanta Sani was, you know, started by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. From then onward, you know, different kind of articles we are getting. Perfect Siddhanta, Sajjanta Sani, from there. And with Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada used to go in different place. Prabhupada speaking, that with Bhaktivinoda Thakur. With Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I used to go to different places because Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to take me with him in different pilgrimage. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada in his whole life, never speak this thing. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is, Prabhupada never speak this way, that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is my father. Never speak. Never, you cannot show even one single right. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, is my father, Prabhupada never speak this way. And Prabhupada also never speak this way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is my father. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur never speak is my son. See, never speak this way. Prabhupada used to speak that whenever I look at Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I find that Radharani is there. This is the darshan of Prabhupada. Prabhupada speaking, whenever I look at Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I find Radharani is there. Exactly. Prabhupada speaking. Exactly, Radharani there. So, this material darshan is, you know, totally prohibited actually. So, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to take Prabhupada with him in different pilgrimage. Now, in Puri also, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to stay there in Shatasang. No, actually it is near Haridas Thakur Samadhi. There Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do bhajan. That place is now changed. And just right hand side, there actually Chaitanya Math branch, mot is there. There. The total area was garden actually at the sea bank. It's a very nice place. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do bhajan there under the guidance of Haridas Thakur. That time actually Bhaktivinoda Thakur retired, first Bhaktivinoda Thakur took decision to go to Vrindavan. First, after my retirement, I can go to Vrindavan, do bhajan. That place is also there, you can remember, near Jagannath temple there in Puri Radhakunda, one Jagannath temple there. That is called Sikhetra. In Vrindavan, it is called Sikhetra. You know, one Jagannath temple there, you cannot remember. Are at the bank of Radhakund. If you do Radhakund Parikram, then you can find one Jagannath temple. That Jagannath temple actually, as per glorification, it is called Sikhetra coming here. Sikhetra. Nilachaldam there. Just near that, there is one bhajan kutir of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur made it. There, one nice bhajan kutir. Sananda Sukhata Kunjo is also there. There. Sananda Sukhata Kunjo is actually by Lalita Sakhi. Eh? Lalita Sakhi. Lalita Sakhir, Ajagga Kinkari, Vinod Dhariche Pai. Bhaktivinoda Thakur are giving his own identity. I am following whom? Lalita Sakhi, Kinkari, Manjariya. Kamal Manjari. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur make one nice place there. Very nice place. They used to do bhajan. And Prabhupada used to go sometime there. You do bhajan there. There was one swing. Prabhupada used to sit in swing, like Radharani, Manjari, Radharani. Used to swing and speak Harikatha. Very nice. Used to. There. That place is there. At present under the control of Chaitanya Math. Anyway, so there actually used to go. But in the meantime, Tarakeshwar is actually material people, they run there, they think this is our Mahadev. But actually that Tarakeshwar Mahadev is not ordinary Mahadev. He is a Sadashiv. But ordinary people, they don't know. A Sadashiv. Like there, in Gopeshwar Mahadev is not ordinary Mahadev. He is Sadashiv, Advaita Gosai. He is Advaita Gosai actually. People cannot understand, Vishnu Tattva. So, Mahadev Shankar Bhagavan, Vaishnavaram Yatha Sambhu came in dream, giving instruction to Bhaktivinoda, what you are doing for Gaur Dham, which is also Vrindavan, secret Vrindavan. You took decision to go there. Who is there to serve this Gaur Dham? Bhaktivinoda Thakur. In dream, Shankar Bhagavan came and giving blessing and giving instruction. Don't go. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur stop is going to Vrindavan. Then coming here, then we can get Bhaktivinoda. Otherwise Bhaktivinoda took decision to go there. Now when Bhaktivinoda Thakur was there in Nilachaldam, that time when took retirement, used to do bhajan under the guidance of Namacharya Haridas Thakur. That time Bhaktivinoda used to explain Chaitanya Bhagavat and Chaitanya Charitamrita. Nobody can find this kind of explanation. Even today, if you go through the explanation by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Gita explanation, you can go. You can see so easy representation. So easy. So easy. Gita commentary, Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Charitamrita, so easy commentary. Very At that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do bhajan there. One day, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, giving instruction to Bimala Prasad. Bimala Prasad, I have some seva there in Calcutta. Bengal. I have to go, and in the meantime, you will have to speak Harikatha, because for 7 days I cannot stay. I am going there in Bangla to do some. I have some seva there, so you will have to speak Harikatha there. Well, as you like. As you like, I can speak Harikatha. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, and Prabhupada started explaining Chaitanya Charitamrita. Oh my God! When Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, then Prabhupada started explaining Chaitanya Charitamrita. All those Saujiya, they used to attend the Harikatha of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they become very angry. Why you are speaking this way? After that, they took decision to kill Bimala Prasad, Prabhupada. We can kill you. If we can find you outside, we can beat you. We can kill you. Took decision. In the meantime, Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur came. Both Bhaktivinoda Thakur when came, he find that the audience, number of audience is very few. A few number of audience hearing. Bhaktivinoda Thakur couldn't understand why. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, today also you will have to speak Harikatha. I am actually just coming, you will have to speak Harikatha. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to hear what he is speaking. Then after that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is secretly hearing what he is explaining about Chaitanya Charitamrita. Oh my God! He is explaining this way. Absolute truth. Nobody can bear this kind of naked truth. Oh, now I know why people are not coming to attend your Harikatha. I know, now you know. They cannot just bear the absolute truth. Oh, you will have to speak this way. Thakur, they want to kill me. Well, if I go outside, well, I hear. Then I can give you order. Actually, you can go to Navadipdham, Brajapattan. It's called Brajapattan, which is called Chandrasekhar Acharya Bhavan, Chaitanya Math. That time is a unique place, very high. Even flat cannot touch so much, but when I was there, 2000 flat, I was there speaking Harikatha for a long time in Chaitanya Math. That time I was, you know, in water, all around water. So much water, 2000, big water. That time I was there. Anyway, that place, Pope Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving instruction, you can take this Harinam Mala, special Harinam Mala giving to you, go and do Harinam there. Because Harinam is the only solution, any problem. Though we never like to find solution through Harinam, but still, Harinam is the only solution. If Harinam is coming out of your lotus mouth, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, everything can be solved. No problem can be there. That is why Bhaktivinoda Thakur standing instruction, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you can find there in Sananda Sukhuta Gunj, that you can do Harinam in tongue, go on doing Harinam all the time, and do seva in hand. You go on doing. Someday, pure Harinam can come out of it. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving standing instruction. You all go on doing seva whole day and night. Never try to take rest. Rest means death. Never try to. Go on doing seva. And speak out Harinam, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. While going to market, while going to, anywhere. Bus, truck, don't stop. If you want to understand who is pure devotee, you can watch. His tongue always dancing. Anywhere, train, bus, anywhere going, tongue dancing. Never stop doing Harinam. Constant remembrance, I yesterday told you. So, actually, Bhakti, it is the standing instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You go on doing Harinam in face. Maybe, Shankhanam means you have to count Harinam, okay. But sometimes you are doing so much seva. So, that time also don't stop speaking Harinam. Go on doing Harinam. Don't stop Harinam. Who can say when I am going to leave my body? Fraction of second I can go. That time I am without Harinam. I cannot get attain that kind of big problem. So go on speaking Harinam all the time. Don't stop. Now, by the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada coming here in Bhajabhattam, there is all, nothing there. Forest. Forest, actually, Guru Maharaj speaking, Maharaj, only 50 years back, if I leave you here in Mayapur, at night time, 7 o'clock, you can fear. All around, jackal and snake. All around, so dangerous place. Nobody dare to come night time. So, only 50 years back, not that. Within 20 years, I have seen so much change. 20 years only. I used to stand at the bank of Ganga and do Harinam. I was feeling I am in Vrindavan. So nice, all gone, broken, making hotel, this, that. But Aprakita Vrindavan is Vrindavan. Aprakita is, Navadvip Dham is Aprakita Vrindavan. So nobody can disturb. But materially you can see there is hotel, so much disturbance. Bhaktivinoda is speaking, they are on net. They are not actually touching Dhamma. Bhaktivinoda is speaking in Dham Mahatta, actually they are on a net by Mayadevi. Net. Arranged by Mayadevi. They are not actually touching Dhamma. But Srila Bhakti Pumas Purgasam is touching Dhamma, doing Harinamani. Prabhupada touching. All Guru Varga. You cannot find. He says, so much trouble here, Maharaj, so much disturbance. Yes. Prabhupada used to do Harinam. Koti Harinam Jagya. Koti Harinam Jagya. I already know it's a topic of Prabhupada, actually used to do. After that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also after retirement, you know, I already told you, make this Sananda Sukhada Kunjo. It is 1899 or 98, I forget. There Bhaktivinoda Thakur make Bhajan Kutir. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to explain Srimad Bhagavatam in noon time, 3 o'clock or 4, 3 to 4, within that time. Every Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do Bhajan upstairs, you know? You don't know. When I was in Vrindavan doing, and now I am doing some seva here also, that time was totally. When I used to come here, they give me place at the at the adjacent room of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Baranda. They don't allow anybody. I am lucky actually. They allow them to stay there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur room here, I used to stay there, long time. And evening time, I used to stay Garikata down, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Bhajan Kuti. Anyway, you can find one small temple, very small. One cave there, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Bhajan Kuti left. There, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to keep Gaur Gadadhar Vigraha, very small. Gaur Gadadhar. And all the time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur doing Harinam with closed eyes. Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj, Sevak, never allow anybody to meet Thakur. No. Any special case, I mean somebody sent by Bimala Prasad, then allow. If somebody is sent by Bimala Prasad or some, then allow. Otherwise, Bhaktivinoda Thakur always in Lila. Bhaktivinoda Thakur always in Lila, always deep into Lila. Cannot see anything outside. Aulubi Maharaj, you heard the name of Aulubi Maharaj? Elder brother of Sri Keshav Goswami Maharaj. In previous home. Elder or, you know, junior, senior, this kind of word I don't like to speak, but to who is brother, who is, you know, I should not speak this way. Anyway, to identify this, when he came to take darshan of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada's Bimala Prasad sending, he going there and Sevak asking, who sent you? Actually, Bimala Prasad sending. Bimala Prasad Saraswati Thakur. Well, wait. Then Sevak, Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj. That Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj is a Sevak of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Don't confuse between two Krishnadas Baba. One Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj is our Guru Varga. You know, he's a disciple of Prabhupada, used to do Harinam all the time. Just I was speaking about his topics in boat. And this Babaji Maharaj is a sevak of Bhaktivinod Thakur. Bhaktivinod Thakur disciple. Then, that, you know, Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj going up, very softly, gently asking, Thakur, Thakur, very softly, so that Bhaktivinod Thakur never feel disturbance. After that, gradually, when understand that somebody calling me, then what happens? Then after that, Babaji Maharaj, I mean Sevak speaking, somebody coming to take darshan of your lotus feet, Vimalapusa Sandhi, then giving permission. Okay, yes. Then after that, when coming, old Maharaj directly speaking. But when I enter the room of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I go mad. What I see? Some jyoti coming, light. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur very, very gently open his eyes. This way. Because all the time, eyes closed. He cannot look. Who? Gama. Looking. Only when I was speaking, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur looking at me, I think all my, you know, dirty thing gone, looking at me. That kind of sight I have never seen in my life. Only my seeing, that kind of looking, I cannot forget. I cannot forget. My Guru Maharaj also speaking, when at the time of leaving body, when Prabhupada looking at me, I was messaging lotus feet of Prabhupada, Prabhupada opening easy chair. Then opening who? Open his eye. Oh, Pranamananda. Guru Maharaj speaking, that kind of, you know, looking, sight, and that kind of speech, full of love, I never heard, never seen. Guru Maharaj used to say, as if echo going on, as if Popat calling me, oh, Paramananda, Pranamananda. When Prabhupada calling me, oh, you Paramananda coming. Guru Maharaj said, I never in my whole life, I cannot forget. So much love and affection is there in this speech. Oh, who? Pranamananda. And looking at me. Last sight. After that, within 1 or 2 days, Prabhupada left body. Last moment. I am speaking about last moment when Guru Maharaj and Paramananda Prabhu. Paramananda Prabhu and Pranamananda, both of them used to do serve Prabhupada at last moment. 12 hours by Paramananda and 12 hours divided. 6 to 6, 6 to 6. 12 hours by Pranamananda, 12 hours by Paramananda. Now, only when speaking, I can never forget. Bhaktivinoda Thakur looking at me, not speaking anything, only looking at me, giving glance, merciful glance at me. I mean, all the time Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to stay in Lila Saran. All the 24 hours, no breakage. Only 2 or 3 times milk, this much milk, only milk. One time little bit prasadam, little, this much. Prasadam actually, some fruits and this, that. Boiled apple, this, that. Very little. And 3 times milk, nothing else. All the time in Lilasaran, Ashtakalin Lilasaran. Practically. And always looking at Gaur Gadha, just left hand. Gaur Gadha there. After Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, that Gaur Gadha Vigraha was installed in the main temple, now you find. But that was stolen. After that, Prabhupada again installed, same thing. That photo I have, the origin, that Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to receive, that photo I have. In Vishnupriya books, Vishnupriya book, I already published. Vishnupriya. And special Siddhanta about Vishnupriya in Bengali. There I give a photo, unique. Actually, when Bhaktivinod Thakur was in home also, that time when doing service, everything, that time also, Aprakrit Vaishnava. Someday Bhaktivinoda Thakur taking, you know, just like, you know, taking rest or like that. Yeah. Bhaktivinoda Thakur taking rest when? Actually evening time, eight to nine, Bhaktivinoda Thakur to take rest. And night time, 12:30 or 12, used to get up and sit and do Harinam whole night. That was the usual practice. It was the usual practice of Bhaktivinoda Thakur to do Harinam night time. Daytime always used to do. Someday when completing office job, coming back, you know, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur sitting doing Harinam, but all other people the watching Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone. As if no life, no symptom on life. They are shocked. They are calling Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Thakur, dikhe. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not responding. They say, Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone? Maybe leave his body? They touch body for long after. Open eyes. What happens? Why you disturb me? We disturb you. Please excuse me. What happens? Actually, Indra Maharaj from heaven, they called me. I was there in heaven. Because on some issue, specially, there was a debate going on. Argument. They cannot take decision, Siddhanta. So, Indra Maharaj invite me and take me there. I was there doing in Shabha. And in the meantime, he called me, disturb me. Yes, doing specially this way. That time, I mean 150 years back, that time, Prabhupada was the topmost, you know, you see, what you say? Jyotish, astrology. Astrology, you can say, but astrology is not complete term. Jyotish means all more. Astrology means, astronomy. Astronomy are also different thing. Anything there in English is not complete when I say it. Jyotish is a part of Veda. Jyotish Shastra is a part of Veda. It's a vast chapter. The Prabhupada was so topmost that time. At present you are following P.N. Bakshi Panjiga, you know P.N. Bakshi? P.N. Bakshi, Bengali Panjiga. That P.N. Bakshi was the student of Prabhupada. Even those who are doing research work in astrology, astronomy, still today they are following the papers of Prabhupada, Bimala Prasad, written 150 years back. So scientific and, you know, precise. Still today, those who are doing research, new research men, they are bound to follow his papers, what he wrote before. So unique, unparalleled, unbeaten. Prabhupada's calculation was so accurate, you cannot imagine. One example I am giving. One day somebody coming to Bimala Prasad, that time Bimala Prasad was not so aged, maybe 12, 13, 14 years. Somebody requesting, I know you know astrology, could you speak about my lifespan when I am going to leave my body? Hey, please speak me. Then Prabhupada calculate and speaking him that in the year of this time, this hour, this minute, this second, this fraction of second, you calculate. Yes. Exactly that time that man leave his body. But this news when Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur came to know that Bimala Prasad just speaking the lifespan, I mean, calculate without after calculation speaking in lifespan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur chiding him. Never try to speak this kind of thing in front of people. Don't try to speak this way. Otherwise, they cannot get inspiration to do anything. Those who are making building, multi-story building, if he is going to know that tomorrow I am going to die, who can make a multi-story building? It is also a magic spell of Maya Devi. Don't speak that way. He will have to suffer his karma pal. All bonded souls, they will have to suffer karma pal. Karma pal means about the previous activity they will have to suffer. If you speak this way, they can stop. So why so much problem in our bhajan society, bhajan field? Can you speak one point? Bhaktivinod Thakur is speaking repeatedly. Because they are leaving their family, father, mother, wife, everything, immature state. They are not mature. They are not mature. Why they leave? They think in family life we cannot get anything, no prosperity is there. At least if I go to this powerful Vaishnava, I can get some name and fame, ultimately position, rank and foreign also I can go. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his article, so many articles, you must read. Patishtasa Bharjan, one article. Koli, so many articles Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Sajjantasani. So many articles. Sadhu Sangha Pranali Vichar, the procedure how you can do perfect Sadhu Sangha. All scientific article, if you go, you can go mad. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur crying. Those acharyas, if they can follow, Rasamrita Sindhu, if they can follow Sanatana Goswami Pad, Hari Bhakti Vilas, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they will have to consult and take decision according to that scriptural analysis written by, compiled by Sanatana Goswami. But we are very sorry, if they cannot, you know, consult, they are bound to do some mistake. They are bound to make mistake. And if one acharya making mistake, then chain-wise everybody help to solve. Jiva Goswami Pad giving. Yesterday I was speaking about Jiva Goswami Pad, speaking this thing. Sabde parechani snatam brahmani upasamasrayam. One sloka you heard many times. Sabde parechani snatam brahmani upasamasrayam. Jiva Goswami Pad giving in Sandarbha, giving Bhakti Sandarbha. That if Gurudev is not perfect, if Gurudev is not Sadguru, what do you mean by Sadguru? Everybody can fight with each other. My Gurudev is Sadguru. Your Gurudev fighting with you. You understand what you mean by Sadguru? You understand? Don't understand. Sadguru means, Sat means Asti. Eternal existence is there, unique Dham. Also, Nitya Siddha is okay. Sadhan Siddho, when Sadhan Siddho, also he can find some eternal existence in it. It's all the way same. Follow. If eternal existence there, then is Asti mean his existence is eternal. Not that today Gurudev dies, they die, everything finish. Not that. Then and only then you can say he is Sadguru. Follow what I say? Sadguru. Now, if you can take shelter of a Sadguru, then you can get benefit. Jiva Goswami was speaking. Then you can get benefit. If you follow Gurudev. Second point is that Sabde Parecha Nishnatam means Shabda Brahmani Nishnatha Para Brahmani. Shabda Brahma means he is versed in scriptural analysis. He is knowing big Vedanta, all Siddhanta is knowing. That's why we find one sloka in Chaitanya Chaitanya. Siddhanta buriya chitte nakaro alas, yahaite Krishna lage sudhira manos. Siddhanta, regarding Siddhanta, if you show, exhibit lethargy, lethargy means no energy. Ah, useless, I'm tired. No. Siddhanta buriya chitte nakaro alas. Don't show lethargy, don't show lazy attitude. Siddhanta boliya chitte na karo alos. Yaha ite Krishna lage sudhiro manos. Then and only then you can get strong attachment with Krishna. Otherwise, no. So, Jiva Gosai was speaking, Sabde parecha nisnatam min, Sabda brahmani, para brahmani cha nisnatam. Nisnatam in verse. It's knowing everything. Jiva Gosai was giving argument, if you approach your Gurudev regarding one Siddhanta, if your Gurudev cannot give judgment properly, then you are misguided. If he cannot speak anything, then you are misguided. You can misunderstand Gurudev. I ask question, Gurudev cannot speak. Follow, you see. Then Gurudev cannot speak, Siddhanta. Then Sishya in trouble. That is why in Hari Bhakti Vilas it is then Sabde Parecha Nisnatam. And after that also third point. We can find all those points in Bhaktivinoda Thakur itself. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is Sadguru topmost. Sabde paricha nishnatam after the brahmani upasamasray. Shabda brahma means all scriptural analysis, is verse. Parabrahma means in Supreme Lord. He has strong affinities, relation with Krishna, Gauranga. That third point is that such a way Gurudev is on such a platform that he is Brahmani Upasamasrayam. Brahmani mane Shabda Brahmani, Parabrahmani, in the Leela of Krishna, in the Leela of Gauranga, totally Upasamasrayam. Uposam mean relief. Uposam mean, in Sanskrit word, Uposam mean to get relief. Uposam. So why this word they use here? Now, that is why, if he is Nitya Siddha, then okay. If he is Sadhan Siddha, still okay. Because Sabda Brahmani, Parabrahmani, Uposamasrayam. Uposamasrayam means Uposamasrayam. Uposamani, his heart is equipoised, balanced. There is no demand, no kamana, nothing, no smell of kamana. Follow? Uposaman means his disease is not there. No kama, no desire, nothing, only bhakti and bhakti. He likes to love Krishna, do seva. Why Prabhupada opening this thing, this mart? Why? Why Prabhupada opening Bhaktivinoda Institute, this, that? Not material activities. It's called dham seva. We are always misusing the philosophy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. That's why you are getting punishment. Why you are getting punishment? Unnecessarily. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking, what Prabhupada is speaking, if we can follow, then there is no question of disturbance. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you have to follow this article. Bhaktivinoda Thakur crying. If those acharyas, they are not careful about this thing, then in near future, everything can be finished. Bhaktivinoda Thakur crying that time, 150 years back. If those acharyas, if they are not careful about this thing, very shortly, Mayadavi can finish everything. Bhaktivinoda Thakur passing this kind of remark. If gradually you find the number of renounced order increasing, then it is at a game and plotting of Mayadavi. If you find gradually the number of renounced order, I mean sannyas, Brahmaji, they are red clothes, life, or increasing, then it is a plotting of Maya. Then how is possible to get red cloth? My Guru Maharaj is saying for a long time, after 5-10 years, Prabhupada used to give red cloth to somebody. Follow what I say. 5-10 years, Prabhupada watching what is the activity, character, mood, everything. After that, Prabhupada. 10 years, 12 years, 15 years, oh, white cloth. After that, Prabhupada thinking, he can be given red cloth? Or what? Thinking. What to speak about sannyas? 25 years gone, 20 years gone, everything, they are expressing so much capacity, like Keshav Goswami Maharaj. He says the Aprakrit Vedanti. Vedanta Darshan, Keshav Goswami is so unique. I go mad. I identify Madha Maharaj. How you are writing this way? Speaking this way. Kesab Goswami. So powerful. Still we find Kesab Goswami Maharaj could not get sannyas from Prabhupada. Took sannyas from Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami. What to speak? My Guru Maharaj also, Prabhupada took decision to give sannyas to Guru Maharaj. At the meantime, Prabhupada lived body in the meantime. Took decision. I can give sannyas to Purnamananda. But in the meantime, Prabhupada gone. Then Guru Maharaj crying, Prabhupada wanted to give me sannyas, what to speak. Then in a night time, in the morning time, around 2:30 or 3 o'clock, Guru Maharaj speaking. One day I find one dream, I see one dream, in which Prabhupada speaking me sannyas mantra. Hey. Then I break my dream, I get up and get my diary because Guru Maharaj is sleeping this way. Here all diary and books, Guru Maharaj sleeping this way. You can go to Bhajan Kutya Guru Maharaj. And take one diary and write sannyas mantra. What spoken by Prabhupada. Guru Maharaj speaking, Prabhupada promised me, Prabhupada complete his promise. But I cannot express that I took sannyas from Prabhupada. If I act that way, all people can misunderstand me. They can see he is for Pratishtha, he is. So I was bound to take sannyas from Srila Bhaktivinod Thakur Goswami Maharaj. Madhav Goswami Maharaj also took. Bhakti Gaurav Bhaktivinod Thakur Goswami Maharaj. For Bhaktivinod Thakur Goswami Maharaj and for Bhaktivinod Thakur Goswami Maharaj, it was a special case. Prabhupada gives sannyas within 6 months. Quite impossible. Quite impossible. A special case. Within 6-8 months, Prabhupada gives sannyas. And send them in preaching. But for other, no. Yeah. Anyway, this way. So, actually, Bhaktivinod Dara, Prabhupada, I am speaking last Siddhanta actually, Prabhupada requesting us, in our writings and Siddhanta, Prabhupada speaking this way, in our writings, in our Siddhanta, I mean speaking Harikatha, always and every time, we can keep alive this flow of Bhaktivinod Dara. We cannot allow that Bhaktivinod Dara to stop. I mean, it is the blessing of Prabhupada. Bhaktivinod Dara kakhono avaruddha hobe na. Bhaktivinod Dara can never be stopped. Never. So on those days, actually, in front of British people, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to explain Gauranga philosophy. After that, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur was expressing Asustha Leela, I mean sick Leela, where? In Sananda Sukada Kunj. Sananda Sukada Kunj there, Gadroom. One thing important. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing Bhajan Rahasya there in Bhajan Kutir. Bhajan Rahasya, this book compiled by Prabhupada there in the Bhajan Kutir at the bank of Saraswati Nadi. That time Bhaktivinoda Thakur also there in Bhajan Kutir doing two Bhajan Kutir, you know, two rooms. One is Prabhupada, one is Bhaktivinoda. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur expressing anxiety. Why? Because peasant society, they don't like to understand the top secrecy of bhajan. They like to lead their life in a very sahajiya way. Even today, if I speak about absolute truth, they become very angry with us. Yes. They cannot be here. And I am also less interested to speak all this higher philosophy in front of them foolish. Let them take Pushpanna, Chana, Chana Rasa, sweet ball, they can take. And we can take this kind of nectar, what's written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, what's wrong in it? Let them fight with each other. I don't go. I know. They cannot be here. So that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur expressing anxiety. Like same case with Narottama Thakur. When all people, by the meantime, Narottama, Srinivasaji, Ramchandra, I already told, they are pitching massive. Massive way. But still, those are pasanda, brutes, they are passing all rubbish remark about Narottam Thakur. All rubbish. And bring bhajan, then why got paralysis? Huh? They are doing bhajan. Then shisha. This time, Chakravarti, shisha. He was grihastha first. Ramnaran Chakravarti, crying in front of Gurudev, Narottam Thakur. Gurudev, they are passing this kind of remark. I cannot bear. I have to give fitting answer to them. Bless me. In the meantime, when Narottam Thakur going to Ganga to take bath there, shisha helping Gurudev. Gurudev saying helping shisha. Shisha helping? Yes, to take bath. Then like soap, you know, you are rubbing soap, Ganga water rubbing, all body, transcendental body going into Ganga. Narottam Thakur. Here also Prabhupada crying, Bimala Prasad, Thakur, you are expressing sick lila. You like to go away so quickly? You will have to stay more. You will have to stay more to help me. Because I am alone. Nobody in this universe is going to help me to preach the absolute darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Who can? Everybody can attack me. Fight. Stop speaking this kind of thing. You can remember in the you know, Shabha of Maninda Chandra, I already told, I can speak at the time of Prabhupada's appearance, disappearance day there in Puri, Nilachal. Every year I am discussing, by the mercy of Guru Bhargava. There, those Sahajya, Raja Maninda Chandra there. Prabhupada speaking only 5 minutes. After they say, oh sir, stop, we don't like to hear. 5 minutes only, Prabhupada speaking. Within 5 minutes they are starting, you stop, we don't like to hear. Then Prabhupada stop, go away from Sabha. For 3-4 days Prabhupada is fasting. Not taken even water, a drop of water. A drop of water. Prabhupada coming here in Mayadip, Mayapur, then took prasad. When Raja Manindichandra came to know that Prabhupada fasting in my palace for 3-4 days, Manijendra crying and brushed into tears. Prabhupada said, I cannot take anything. Because I cannot give you anything. How can I give? I cannot give you. How I can accept anything from you? If you can accept, then I can take. Then Prabhupada crying, Bimala Prasad crying, Thakur, you will have to stay more here in this place. You will have to help me. I am alone, nobody there to help me. Then within 1 or 2 days, Bhaktivinoda Thakur again manifests nice lila, sick lila gone. Bhaktivinoda Thakur revived within 2-3 days. How unique! Then after that, Bhaktivinoda was speaking very freshly. You will have to go to Baligai Sabha. Baligai Sabha, you know, in Mindapur one place. All smarta people, they are fighting with Vaishnava, we can kill you all. Speaking all rubbish, it is not written in scripture. You cannot give skirt thread to everybody. You cannot give diksha. These were fighting. All Brahman and Vaishnava, they took fighting, big fighting. Then one big meeting was arranged, and there the meeting was presided over by whom? Shamananda Parivar? Who? Who? Vishwamananda Dev Goswami. Vishwambarananda Dev Goswami, who is in the line of Samananda Parivar. Unique personality. Unique. He can go mad, all bathe, beyond everything. He was present in the Sabha. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving blessing to Bimala Prasad. Prabhu, you will have to go there and establish Siddhanta and stop their face. How I can go? I am very weak. No, you have to go. My blessing is there, full. Full blessing there, you go. Then Bimala Prasad took kripa upon Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and going, permission, and going to Baligai Sabha in Midnapur. In the way of Kanti, I think. In the way of Kanti. That place, I mean, Digha. One place you heard, Digha, sea beach. Before there, much before. Then Prabhupada reached there. He finds so many educated scholars there. But Vishwambhavananda Goswami presided over that Sabha. He took decision, Vimalapasa Saraswati Prabhu, you will have to pass judgment. You are the only speaker, I cannot allow anybody. You speak, you will have to break their Siddhanta. Maybe 2 days, 3 days can you can take, no problem. You will have to do it. Then Prabhupada started speaking about Brahman and Vaishnava. Who is Vaishnava? Who is Brahman? And what is the qualities of Brahman? What is the qualities of Vaishnavas? What is the stage platform of Vaishnava? What is the platform of Brahman? Prabhupada went on speaking like fire. Like fire. Nobody can stand. All Brahman, they are also big pandit. They stop. Prabhupada cut all Siddhanta, everything. Break. Smashed. And Prabhupada get victory. After that, thousands of people. There was, you know, at least 20,000 people, more than that, 50,000. We cannot count. So much people there. After the meeting was over, when Prabhupada got victory, then thousands of people, they are running towards Prabhupada to take the, you know, dust particle of Prabhupada. Then Vishwambhavananda Goswami took decision, if those people coming, Prabhupada can die. All can fall down to Prabhupada. Then get one big pot. Big pot. Like in the, at the time of festival, we use chana rasa, dal, we keep. There one. A pot, big pot on there. In that pot, he put the lotus feet of Prabhupada and keep water. Give water, give water. Oh, full of water. Oh, people taking little water, all gone. Finish. Then Bhaktivinod Thakur, when Prabhupada come back, Bimala Prasad, Bhaktivinod Thakur embrace and kiss. Bhaktivinod Thakur never think he is my son. Never think he is my son. Many times Bhaktivinod Thakur told, he is not ordinary personality. He is coming from Radharani. Many times Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving blessing to Prabhupada. My Prabhu, you will have to execute some, you know, Siddhanta. What Siddhanta you mean? Nobody going to do it. You will have to do, start Dham Parikrama. You will have to do. You are powerful. All power there with you, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu again. You will have to start Dham Parikrama, Dham Circumbalance, through which this Dham Parikrama, countless people can get benefit. Countless, those who are not knowing, village people, oh Maharaj, we can go take some khichdi there. Also they can get benefit, because anyway they are going to come. We have no money, okay, you can stay. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, through this Dham Parikrama, countless people, Jivatma, can get benefit. You will have to do it. It is your duty. And to establish Daiva Varnasam, you will have to do it. You will have to do it, Daiva Varnasam. Now people, they are misinterpreting what do you mean by Daiva Varnasam. If I explain the meaning of Daiva Varnasam, all people can go against me. They can fight with me. Why you are speaking this way? But they cannot do anything, but I can open and show. It's the Siddhanta Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Gita, Baladev Vidyasana, Vishwanath Chakur, all documents I can. They can come to fight with me. Why you are speaking this way? Maharaj, I am not criticizing. I hate criticizing, but you give me the place, Vyasasana. If I cannot speak the truth, absolute truth, then I will have to go to hell. Be careful. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking, you will have to establish Daiva Varnasam, Dham Parikram, Dham Seva. You have to do. Otherwise, nobody can. Then Prabhupada took power from Bhaktivinoda Thakur and started everything. All Daiva Varnasam. What do you mean by Daiva Varnasam? Someday I can explain a little bit. I knew it is dangerous. Most of the people can come against me. Why are you speaking this way? Still I can speak someday. So Prabhupada, then onward Prabhupada started Dham Seva, oh, big way, enthusiastic way. Prabhupada started. Many times Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, many times, he is not ordinary personality. Bimala Prasad is not ordinary personality. Be careful. Annoda Prasad, one son of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was expressing sick lila. Tremendous headache. He's going to die. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving responsibility to Bimala Prasad. You will have to stay here whole night here in this room and speak Harina, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. You have to speak. No other way. We are going outside. Bimala Prasad doing Harina whole night. Morning time, all people running and coming. They find why they are running. They find that sick man, Annada Prasad, one son of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he is going to leave body. While leaving body, everybody can clearly see some tilak here. They have no, he has no tilak. Automatically one Ramanuja tilak coming on. Ah, tilak, everything, all body, powerful. Then that Jivatma speaking, I was Ramanuja sadhu, previous life. I was committing aparadha unto the lotus feet of this Bimala Prasad Saraswati. Of course, Bimala Prasad Saraswati, this title he got later, but still I am bound to speak, but I love Prabhupada. Actually, he got it after. Then everybody looking, that Jivatma speaking, I was in previous life, I was Ramanuja Sadhu. I committed aparadha. That's why I am bound to come here in the family life of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Now I confess, I beg for pardon, please excuse me, otherwise I cannot get any way out. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you bless him. After the blessing, then go. From then, not then, when Prabhupada took birth, from then Bhaktivinoda Thakur passing remark, he is not ordinary personality. Is who is he? You can understand someday. Now, by the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we are having so much facility today. But we are so much lucky, so lucky, so lucky, so lucky. But still, we are unlucky because we are acting just like Jodu Bangsi. You know, those who are in Jodu Dastini, they are lucky because they have come in the line of in the family and tradition of. Whom? Krishna himself. But still their brain gone out of all. Yes, facing Leela. Actually Leela. Not, I am not speaking that way. We are so lucky, so lucky, so lucky. I cannot speak. I am so much proud. I am from Gauriya Math. I am going to get the blessing of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Still I am unlucky. When I hear this and that, when I find this situation and cry, how to rectify this situation? Prabhupada, you will have to come. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you will have to come. Because you gave everything. Vancha kalpatir vasikapasindhavesha.